The replacements for the failed eggs in the wild come from the Los Angeles, San Diego, and Oregon zoos, as well as the World Center for Birds of Prey in Boise, Idaho. With so few condors remaining as the recovery program got underway in the 1980s, the limited breeding capacity and genetic makeup of those few remaining birds were a source of concern. 400 birds later, those fears have disappeared with the groundbreaking success of the zoo conservation programs.
When we were first getting involved with California condors, we had a great deal of experience working with other endangered species, including the Andean condor. And we were able to reduce our learning curve, but you have to also take into account and appreciate the anxiety levels associated with working with events for the very first time. When the first egg was brought in from the wild and incubated at the San Diego Zoo and hatched there, and it had never been done before. And knowing that you were dealing with, at that time, around 25 condors left in the world, and how everyone was so precious and important, and anticipating the condor's needs so that it would reproduce in a zoo setting. And there were a lot of concerns about whether or not that would be able to be accomplished. So there was a lot that we were learning as we went. The aspect of puppet rearing had never been done before. So we were raising condors in a manner that we had hoped that they would become capable parents as well in the wild. We're talking about a species that lives more than 60 years. That requires a great deal of mentorship from their parents and learning a lot of behaviors over about a 2-year period. And we were escalating that timetable to get birds back out into the wild.